So hi everybody, welcome back to my channel. This is Kriti and I'm so excited to have Pravan with me to talk about the local elections which is happening on 16th of November, that is on Tuesday. Pravan, tell us what is this local election and tell us more about your take on all the elections thing here.
Absolutely, and thank you for having me on this video. It's such a pleasure. My name is Torben Alexander Klingert, and I guess the reason why, firstly, I'm very involved in this election is that I'm the founder of an initiative called Project Vote Tech, which is a platform that's meant to be informative and encouraging about voting in elections in Denmark, especially for internationals who live here. When it comes to the local elections coming up, these in a way they're very important because in a way they're the type of elections that allow for the most amount of people to vote. Theoretically, you have both, I guess, if you can group them in native Danes, and you have internationals, and then you have a third group, EU citizens, who can vote. And you can vote here if you've lived here for a period of 4 years, or you're an EU citizen, or from Iceland or Norway. What they're really about is twofold. So firstly, there's what's known as the municipal elections. And they lead to the council here. Mm-hmm. And on top of that is the mayor.
Yeah.
And then on the other hand, there's the regional elections.
Yes.
There's five regions in Denmark. The regions, they focus very much on healthcare, for example. Mm-hmm. But other focus areas include the environment and the green agenda. That is where they have some overlap with the municipal elections. Mm-hmm. There's also a lot of green agenda there. But the municipality is a little bit more localized and a bit more... there are some other topics there as well that they focus on. So it's anything from schooling, from job centers, from integration, any span that really is localized and in a way what actually affects, you know, people on a day-to-day basis that really matters on your day-to-day.
To tell how to vote in Denmark, we have a system called one cross to rule them all. That means if you put two X's on your ballot that you get at the station, then it's invalid. Two crosses become invalid. One cross to rule them all, that's it. You can either put that cross on a person or on the list, and the list would be a party. Now, if you put that on the list, then the vote will go to the party and the first person in the line of that party. Normally an older person, man or female, who's gonna be the mayor. So, if you find that one person is in your particular interest and that person you wanna vote for, then you have to find that name particularly and put a cross on that. And I hence that. Put a cross on that person and then don't do anything more. Don't put crosses elsewhere, make hearts, make a dinosaur, because if you do that, it becomes invalid. That is the case of the Danish tutorial, How to Vote.
I have Nikki here on my channel. And first of all, I want to say, Nikki, thank you so much for all the work that you are doing on the expats in Copenhagen group. Especially, you know, converting all those Danish conversations to English and doing so many work. So thank you so much.
Well, thank you for having me. And
yes,
it's been my huge pleasure to do it. So
yeah.
Thank you. Yeah.
And today, because we are focusing on the voting, what should internationals consider before they go on Tuesday and vote?
That's a very good question. I think one very, very important thing to consider is that there's a huge difference between national level and local level. On the national level, you have these, you know, mostly established parties, the Social Democratic Party, the Liberal Party, and so on. And they're all governed by ideologies, you know, they are socialist, or they're liberals, or conservatives, or whatever. On a local level, it's much more up in the air. Like, of course, you have an ideology that controls what you fundamentally believe, but it's much more pragmatic. It's much more a matter of cooperation, much more a matter of you have some concrete issues that you want to address. And you can find some mayors, for example, from liberal parties who are much more social democratic than some of the social democratic politicians in other parts of the country.
Yeah.
That's also what makes local politics so difficult, because you can't really use that ideological platform as your, you know, one and two steering aim. So the best thing I can say to an international who wants to get involved in local politics or wants to vote is to really do their research. Really research the candidates, talk to them if possible. But of course they all have a moral compass, they all have an underlying idea of where the society should go. But local level is much more complex, there's a lot more alliances going on than at the national level. So it's a bit more complex, but it's also much more concrete and close to you as a citizen than at the national level.
So you can always go and read and talk to them?
Absolutely, absolutely. If you have, well, there's so many topics that could be discussed and covered, and what is important really matters, is really different from person to person. So if you have a topic, let's say it's childcare, for example, well, go and talk to some of the candidates that come from parties that you think are interesting. We all know more or less which parties we don't want to vote for various reasons. But if you have like two or three candidates left or parties, well, maybe look into them then. Go and talk to them, address them, find out where they are, or at least do research, find out what is interesting for them. And then, as has also been mentioned tonight, I will actually recommend voting young, because young people are inherently more favorable of change and reforms than the more established people. So if that's something that's interesting, if you want to really transform things, then going young is actually a quite good choice.
My name is Emil Moserlund, and I'm a candidate here in Copenhagen Municipality for the City Council. I work in National Parliament for the previous climate minister. I'm also a climate advisor myself, and I'm also the initiative behind Do Democracy Better campaign, which is to progress and to aim for international to vote more for the election, because right now too few of you guys are voting, and that's a damn shame. That's why you don't have representation at the moment.
Mm-hmm. So, as you mentioned that very few of us are voting, could you tell us why it is important for all the internationals to go on Tuesday and vote?
First of all, it is democracy. Yeah. This is democracy. We need to make sure that everyone can be a part of that democracy. People are coming here from all over the world, contributing to the society, to the system, but not taking part of that democracy that they are a part of. And that's a huge shame. 150,000 people living Copenhagen alone, that is of expats or international background. 20% of them vote. And we have a turnout rate in Denmark for this municipality election at 85%, 80%. So you can see that's a huge difference. And that is why internationals, and I have many friends who are internationals, I were myself international while I lived abroad for many years, they have no representation at all. There's no one speaking for the international community at all. And I've taken that oath upon myself to make sure that people actually be more aware of that they can vote, because that is the main thing. People do not know they can vote. If they do vote, then we can change a little bit more about Copenhagen, because only 1,000 individual votes can take a mandate. Only 1,000. So 150,000 extra votes, you can see how that can switch up things, right?
Yeah, as you mentioned, you're 28 years old. Could you tell us why it is also important for young people, you know, to go out and vote?
First of all, young people has the lowest turnout rates in Denmark. Mm-hmm. So it's very important to young people do democracy. Second thing is that the young generation were the one that put climate on the agenda. We were the one making that happen all over the world, also in Denmark. In 2019, we had the national election, and that was the first where all the parties said, this is going to be the climate election. And that was due to our voting, that was due to our voice. And this multi-party election also have to be about climate. Of course, there's many other things that's important, expats, for example, but right now we're in that critical crisis. And if young people don't turn out to vote, then they don't get representation at the moment. And right now, right at this second, only 3 people in city council is below 30. And that's out of 55 seats. 3 people below 30. I'm one of those who's running for that young mandate, because I want to be the 4th that is going into city council. Because otherwise, where are we going from here?
Yeah. Now I have with me Louise, and Louise, could you tell us a little bit about yourself and which party you represent for the election, which is on Tuesday?
Yes, I'm 25 years old, and I'm a student at Copenhagen Business School, where I study at my master's at International Business and Politics, and I'm running for the Danish Liberal Party, also called Venstre. And I'm running for the first time. And then I'm actually also the candidate for the youth department of the Liberals in Copenhagen.
Why it is important for international to go, you know, on Tuesday and vote?
Yeah, it's really important that you use your right to vote. I mean, your voice counts just as much. And it's important to actually have local politicians who will prioritize the international community, who remember all the internationals who actually live in Copenhagen. And you need to have access to free and easy Danish lessons.
Yeah.
We need some good facilities in the international house, some good career programs to help international students get into the Danish job market after they finish. And all these kind of things won't be prioritized if you don't have local politicians who really focus on this area.
So your focus on like the youth and on internationals.
Yeah.
Could you elaborate a little more on your areas which you're focusing right now?
Yeah, I mean, this is a big focus for me also because I study with a lot of international students, and I've talked to them about not being able to get in contact with the municipality on English and stuff like that. And I think it's really important to prioritize. And except from the international community, I'm also prioritizing a greener Copenhagen, where we act both ambitious but also innovative to show the rest of the world that you can both be an international capital but also be green.
Yeah.
Yeah, and then I also want to focus on the youth of Copenhagen. Right now there are only three people under 30 in the Copenhagen municipality, and I think that means that some of the things that are important for the youth are not prioritized.
Yes.
That is, for example, like making sure we have a good nightlife, and making sure there are harbor baths and places like where the youth can meet with their friends and stuff like that.
So the ratio is not quite balanced between youth and...
It's not. Okay. Hopefully it will be better after this election.
And what about the ratio between men and women in the party?
Yeah, there's definitely also more men like in politics, and definitely in local politics. So it would be nice with more women and more young people.
Yeah. My name is Stine Lindemann, and I'm running for an independent list called Rolig Revolution. I almost want to show because it's a weird word. Rolig, which means like calm or easygoing, and revolution is like a revolution. Rah! So it's two very different things put together, because I really want to create some change, but it's not that I want to make a lot of like crazy trouble. I'm trying to get voted in to sit in the city council in Copenhagen so I can come inside and actually be a part of the decision processes. Because normally what I make a living of is that I'm an artist, and I make these different very kind of social projects, working with different minority groups and doing big scale art projects. It's really fun. But I also do a lot of activism. So it's a lot of different fields. It's both with an environment that we need to have because the climate change is coming, so we need to really change the society. It's also within anti-racism, especially in Denmark. We really have been having some problems, to say the least. We've been having a lot of straightforward racist parties getting into to government, and not government, sorry, to parliament, which is plenty bad. And also a lot of different social causes. So I've kind of been on the outside following politics really closely, getting more and more frustrated and angry, feeling ignored. And then I thought, what if I could try and get inside? So I'm not just standing outside yelling, but I'm inside doing something.
And Steen, what do you think that, you know, because I'm also an artist here in Denmark, so what are the challenges that you think that artists face here in Denmark?
Oh, well, it's like for one, it's pretty much important to make impossible to make a living. Like I usually say that half of the reason I can make a living as an artist because I'm just used to living for nothing.
Yeah.
Like, I'm really good at not spending any money. That's half of it, because it's incredible how difficult it is. I think some of the good things that we have as artists is that there's a lot of foundations that where you can apply to get money to do projects. And I found for me that's the way, instead of trying to do like art pieces and selling them through galleries, yeah. instead I create these projects where I work together with a lot of different types of institutions and peoples and kind of think the whole, I think the whole project as my art piece,
yeah.
as well as the art piece we then make within the project. And for me, that's been the way that I can make it work, but it's still, difficult.
So would you be focusing more on also like the artist, how you know they can also thrive here in Denmark, especially even international artists who are doing in English?
Well, I decided to have a really narrow focus in my campaign, which is all about the housing market, basically yeah. because I read that half of the rising inequality in Denmark is due to the housing market. So yeah. I thought if I can change that, then that can better a lot of things that can better everyone.
Yeah.
But of course, if I then manage to get voted in, then I have to have an opinion on everything.
Yeah.
And of course, being an artist and knowing how difficult it is, that will inform it. And I think often the way that the politicians in power try to help artists is blind to how we are actually living. For example, with the pandemic, they tried to give out all this help to give people some money from the art foundation, but the requirements for how much money you needed to make to get this was so high that like nobody could get it. So I hope that they at least look at this data and kind of realize, oh, okay, actually we have a lot of people who are actually living for so little money. Maybe we need to have a look at that, but I don't know. But I think something like that the council could do is that to help with getting facilities to have like a workspace. A lot of us end up working at home, including myself, to save that bit of money. And I think just making workspaces available in some of the spaces that are often left empty around, like for businesses that aren't used currently.
Yeah.
I think something like that could be a lift, depending a little bit on what you do.
Yeah.
But that could definitely be a start.
So why we should go on Tuesday and vote in Denmark?
Well, hopefully to get an influence. Of course, then, if the politicians don't listen, then it doesn't make a difference. So, of course, try and find someone who actually seems like they're gonna listen. And it's important because if there's one thing I've discovered that I kind of knew already, but the one thing that politicians really care about, it's votes.
Yeah.
So if they realize, oh my god, the international vote is so important, actually that cost us a mandate or that's won us a mandate, you can be sure that at least by the next election cycle they will really prioritize it.
Mm-hmm.
But they won't until they see that it makes a difference. And right now it's not making a difference, and I think that's why they're not prioritizing it, because I don't really understand why the municipal isn't already having a really big focus on this area.
Mm-hmm.
Because if you look at the voting statistics for the local elections compared to the ones for the whole country, it's really a massive difference. And it's mainly because there's a lot of foreigners and international types that can vote when it comes to the local elections. So there should be a hardcore focus on it. And that I see almost none.
Yeah.
There's few exceptions, but almost none. So vote so they get scared. So they're gonna have to prioritize you.
Yes, so vote on Tuesday. Thank you so much, Steen. Thank you.
Thank you.
It was great. It was really interesting to hear the different insights and their all different opinions on different issues, for sure.
And will you be voting on Tuesday?
Absolutely, absolutely.
Yeah.
It was great. Really nice event. I really enjoyed it.
Cool.
Yeah, and will you be voting on Tuesday?
Of course, yes. I will not miss it. Yes.
Thank you.